at Target, and we just met someone here to buy some maternity clothes, a whole two bags worth for $25. And then Charity was at Target with Grandma and Grandpa today, and she found Orajel that was supposedly marked down, but she didn't pick it up. And with Mary teething and another baby on the way, we really need more Orajel.
Yeah, Mary's grumpy today. We'll see if it's still there.
Was like what they
$6.98
were.
For 40
mil.
No, but they were two.
Mommy. John, Daddy.
There's Mary in the mirror. Peter likes dancing in the mirror too. What do you see, Lydia? You see that hair stuff? Don't you have enough hair stuff already?
Can we please go see the guy girls?
Yes, she needs more hair stuff. That's why we don't go to. That's why we don't go shopping very often.
They sold the Orajel that Charity saw earlier, so I guess we'll miss it this time.
Janella's in the car with all her new maternity clothes that we just got, and we got out of Target unscathed. We didn't buy anything.
Yep.
It's going to be our anniversary in about a week, so I thought I would do something special for Janelle. And I didn't tell her what it was. It was going to be a surprise. But she figured it out anyway, of course. I figured she probably would. But Charity figured it out before she did.
Art said we could either go out to eat, or I could buy all the food and cook something myself because I love to cook. But today I feel really nauseous, so I don't feel like cooking. So I just went through the store. And this was the thing that looked really good. Buffalo style chicken strips. I know this is probably not the greatest for you, but this looked the best. I was thinking fried haddock, and then that was gonna take too long. So we ended up with this, and then we got a salad, all the stuff for a salad, and bananas. And this is, I really felt like yogurt. So. Art splurged for me on that. Croutons for my salad. Splurged on some nice Southwestern Caesar dressing, which I'm excited about. And this, my last splurge item, and this screams pregnant food. Farmer Garden Kosher Dill Spears. Now, doesn't that look good? Look at the garlic here. This is just like how I make mine. I mean, they screamed. I needed them, so. This is what I bought for my dinner. A nice salad. I have already had sweet potatoes, so I'm gonna cook up a nice baked sweet potato for the two of us with our pickles and our chicken, and voila, that's my anniversary dinner.
What are we doing after we eat?
We are going to Proctor's Theater, and we're going to see a performance by Cesar Millan. And for those who don't know who Cesar Millan is, he is the doctor, or the dog whisperer. Is that what they call him?
Yes.
Dog whisperer? That doesn't sound right.
It is.
The dog whisperer. And it was a surprise. And I was really good. I didn't think about it. I didn't try to figure it out until today. And then I was trying to get a few hints out of people, and Charity wouldn't tell me, and Art really said I was asking too many questions. And so he did tell me that it started at 8 o'clock. So I put on my thinking cap, and the first thing I thought we were going to do was go to see a movie. And the movie that I've been waiting to come out is Hunger Games 3: The Mockingjay. So I typed that up online. And it doesn't show until next week. So I said, no, can't be going there. So then I said, well, the nice thing Art would do would be like a performance, either an orchestra or like Yo-Yo Ming or whoever that guy.
Yo-Yo Ma.
Yeah, that's him. The guy who does the violin.
Cello.
And so I looked up performances in the area, and there was nothing. So then I went to all the major performance centers. There's SPAC, and there's the Egg. Well, it's not the Egg anymore. What do they call it?
Oh, I didn't
Times
really change
Union
the name.
Complex. Right. Then I went to Proctor's Theater, and lo and behold, at Proctor's Theater was Cesar Millan starting at 8 o'clock, and I went, bingo! go, I think I found it. And of course, when I mentioned that to Art, his lips turned up in the corner, and he's like, how'd you figure that out? So I was surprised. I waited until today to figure it out.
Okay. And we are having Caesar salad, too, before we go see Caesar Milan.
Yes. It's going to taste good, too. So let's go make our salad before things start.
Okay, let's do it. For those of you who know me well, you know that I would not want a dog in my house. But I do like other people's dogs, though. So why am I going to go see the Dog Whisperer? Well, I like this guy. He's really interesting. And I really do like dogs, just not in my house. Of course, they do not allow recording devices, so we are not going to get any recordings of the performance. We're almost ready for a quiet, romantic meal with some empty chairs. Are you going to enjoy it, or will it be lonely?
I'm going to enjoy it, but it's going to be lonely at the same time.
Our meal is ready to go.
It's 11:54, and we have a sick little girl.
I just went to take Lydia potty, and it was a little too late. She had already wet the bed, so I took care of that. Then I went to check on Mary, and there's a big pile of vomit in the crib. So I had to clean out everything in the crib and then go, you know, wash down Mary, change her clothes, and, well, now I'm just rocking her to sleep, trying to get some water down here. Here, Mary, you need some water. Anyway, that's what happens when you're a parent. You have to clean up stuff.
It might be a long night.
It might. I always say, if kids didn't have holes, life would be a lot easier. Right, Mary? But we love you. Hopefully you get better soon.
It's 12:52.
Mary threw up again, so she got both of us this time. So we had to go to the bathroom, clean up, and then get new clothes on, a new blanket. And she can't live without her blankie right here. So Janelle hand washed that and hand dried it so she could have it. And the whole time, poor Mary was crying. She was pointing at her blanket saying, please.
Aww.
So, anyway, she is, she looks like she's getting tired, which is good.
We'll see if she can go to sleep.